और न्यूली अपॉइंटेड आर्मी चीफ जनरल नरवणे इस वक्त प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस कर रहे हैं, वहीं का रुख करते हैं उनकी पहली प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस।
A number of y'all had asked me that what do you see as the way ahead and where would you begin from. So I thought that there is no better place to begin than at the beginning, and that is with ABC. A for allegiance, B for belief, and C for consolidation. Allegiance, as the army or the armed forces, we swear allegiance to the Constitution of India. In fact, be it a jawan or an officer, we take an oath. ईश्वर की शपथ लेता हूं कि विधि द्वारा स्थापित भारत के संविधान का सच्ची श्रद्धा और निष्ठा रखूंगा. And that is what should guide us in all our actions and at all times. But what does this really translate into? What this translates into is also the core values which are enshrined in the preamble to the Constitution. That is justice, liberty, equality, and fraternity. And that is what we are fighting for. When we are deployed on the borders, safeguarding the sovereignty and territorial integrity, it is to secure for our people these core values. And I think that is what we and I would like to say that we need to keep in mind at all times. The second is belief. Belief and faith in ourselves, in our organization, in our superiors and subordinates, in our way of life, in our way of governance. If we have belief in ourselves, then our entire edifice will be strong. And in that case, we will not fall prey to all vile rumors and innuendos. So belief is what will keep us going when the times become tough. C is consolidation. And along with consolidation comes continuity. As you are aware that we are in a very transformative stage. And all this transformation that we are doing, we'll have to consolidate upon them. We'll have to carry forward the initiatives and the policies set by my predecessors and make sure that all of them reach a logical conclusion. Of course, somewhere along the way, there would be mid-course corrections as we set about implementing all these changes. And that's another C, corrections. But we will have to consolidate on all these aspects so that we can then move on to the next set of reforms. I will not run through the entire alphabet, that will take much too long. So I will straight away jump to dotting the I's and crossing the T's. I being integration and T being training. And when I say integration, it is integration within the army and integration within the services. The formation of the CDS and the creation of a Department of Military Affairs is a very big step towards integration. And we on our part will make sure that this is a success. Integration will also be within the army, and the integrated battle groups are just one example of that. But I also want to assure everyone that in this process of integration, we will take everyone along. Nobody will be left behind. But we will make that a success. T is training. I think all of us talk about training, but I'm not talking about training for the past. I'm talking about training for the future. If we want joint structures to work, we'll have to train accordingly. For integrated operations, for joint operations. And we will have to train for future wars. Wars which are going to be network-centric. In a highly complex and VUCA environment. Volatile, uncertain, complex and ambiguous. We'll have to train for the future. And that is where the emphasis of our training will be. Going on ahead, minding the P's and Q's. P being personal, Q being quality. Our personal, our men and women in uniform, are our greatest strength. The man behind the machine is what matters most. We will make sure that our men get the best. And we will look into all their aspirational needs. And when I say the personal, that includes the extended family, which is our veterans who have contributed so much to make the army what it is today, and the extended family of the Veer Naris and other NOKs. All of them, as far as I'm concerned, constitute personnel. And the last is Q, that is quality. We will ensure that we take the best. Quality and not quantity will be our mantra. In whatever we do, whether it is selection of personnel, whether it is acquisition of new equipment, we will focus on quality so that we get the bang for the buck. So that, in a nutshell, ladies and gentlemen, is my vision of where we should be in the years to come. A force which has no doubt where its loyalties lie, which has got a strong sense of belief in itself and its capabilities, which are second to none. We'll make sure that we build upon these strong foundations which have been laid by our predecessors, by esteemed veterans, and continue with those policies. The broad direction that those policies take us towards, and as I said, integrate fully, train for the future, look after our men, and make sure that we always get the best. And if we do that, I feel that in the years to come, we will always be future ready and able to meet whatever challenges are thrown up. Thank you.
सेना प्रमुख मनोज मुकुंद नरवणे, जनरल मनोज मुकुंद नरवणे को आप सुन रहे थे, अपने विजन जो उनका हिंदुस्तान को लेकर, भारतीय फोर्स को लेकर, आर्मी को लेकर जो उनका रोड मैप है, उन्हीं के लफ्जों का इस्तेमाल करूं तो उसका एबीसी, उसका पीक्यू और उसका आईटी समझाते हुए, साफ करते हुए, वो जब से उन्होंने कार्यभार संभाला है वो प्रिपेयर्डनेस की बात कर रहे हैं, हिंदुस्तान को तैयार करने की बात कर रहे हैं और उसी बात को एक बार फिर से अपने इस प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस में दोहराते हुए जनरल नरवणे वो कह रहे हैं कि भारत को फ्यूचर चैलेंजेस के लिए, भविष्य की चुनौतियों के लिए तैयार रहना होगा। देश की सीमा और संप्रभुता की रक्षा सेना का कर्तव्य है और साथ ही उन्होंने ये कहा कि बदलाव की प्रक्रिया में सेना आगे बढ़ेगी और साथ ही सबको साथ लेकर आगे बढ़ेगी। लेकिन जो बड़ी बात अभी तक उनकी इस प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस से निकल कर आई कि भविष्य के लिए सेना को तैयार रहना है, भविष्य की चुनौतियों के लिए तैयार रहना है और इसीलिए बेहतर ट्रेनिंग की जरूरत है, प्रिपेयर्डनेस की जरूरत है, सैनिकों की उम्मीद और जरूरतों पर खरा उतरना है, साफ करते हुए साथ ही सीडीएस की नियुक्ति को एक बड़ा कदम उन्होंने बताया है। फोर्सेस के इंटीग्रेशन के लिहाज से हथियार खरीदना, बेहतर हथियार खरीदना उनकी प्राथमिकता में है, ये भी साफ करते हुए। लेकिन कुल मिलाकर अगर एक वर्ड में से पूरा समाप्त करें भारतीय फौज के लिहाज से, तो वो वही दोहराते हुए प्रिपेयर्डनेस की बात डे वन से वो करते आए हैं कि भारतीय फौज भविष्य की चुनौतियों के लिए, चैलेंजेस के लिए, इम्तिहान के लिए, लड़ाई के लिए तैयार हो और उसी बात पर एक बार फिर उनकी तरफ से जोर दिया गया है।